Wouldn't it be great if we could watch videos and never see this again? In this episode of Brainiacs, we're talking 6G. So not like 6Gs of cash, but 6G wireless technology. For the newest cell phones, you've probably seen ads like this for 5G wireless tech and 5G networks. Like most new technology, it's already creating both excitement and new debates. As for the future, researchers at the NYU Wireless Center at Tandon are exploring 6G wireless for devices and applications beyond our phones.
One of them is to really try to improve virtual reality and especially interactive versions of that, where you're having an interactive session like this, a video conferencing session. So right now people are using Zoom, but you could imagine a future where we have a much richer experience where we both, for example, enter some 3D world and can be able to communicate.
Before we get too deep into the 3D metaverse, let's back up for a second and talk about what 6G really means. Do you know what the G stands for? It's generation, as in sixth generation wireless. I always thought it stood for giga something, but it turns out the latest generations of wireless tech do in fact transfer more gigabits of data faster and with lower latency, which means less of a delay. And that's crucial for devices like this one, which helps the visually impaired navigate in real time.
Front entrance located, 11 o'clock, 17 steps.
The prototype is called Vision to the Fourth, and was created by Professor J.R. Rizzo and his team at NYU Wireless and the NYU School of Medicine. Inspired by his own vision loss caused by a medical condition at birth, Professor Rizzo says the backpack prototype uses technology that's similar to driverless cars.
We've taken primarily stereo cameras, but other sensors, right out of that incredible wave of technology that's been developed for autonomous vehicles. And we've integrated it directly into these book bags so we can do what we like to refer to as quantified environmental analysis. So we take everything from the environment and we kind of extract as many details as possible, and we create microservices to help persons with disabilities.
Extracting all those details takes a ton of computing power, but he says 6G wireless allows that to happen remotely on cloud servers. That means the device can be smaller and lighter and have a longer battery life. And those same benefits apply to AI and to robots, like this one called Solo 12. Developed by NYU Tandon Professor Ludovic Righetti and colleagues at research centers in Germany and France, they're now testing Solo 12 with Wi-Fi.
When I send information to the cloud and then I receive information back, you know, to tell the robot what it needs to do, how much time does it take, right? And ideally, you want this to be as low as possible. And with 6G, maybe we can reach a latency level that is like amazing, exactly what we want, right?
They also want to use wireless to control these robots remotely, which would allow them to help in dangerous situations instead of humans, like to assess damage after a hurricane.
Now you can imagine you have robots that can come and maybe open a door, you know, remove something that fell, maybe detect if there's people that are there that needs medical attention.
He says that reality is at least a decade away, and so is 6G wireless. But it's still exciting to think about how far we've come, especially if you remember this sound. I'm Sapna Parikh. I'll see you next time.